Welcome to Appalachia's Homestead. We just got home. We're gonna make this a one-shot video, so let's hope that we make it through. Oh, look here. Who are you? Oh, goodness. Where's Ginger? She was just right over there. Just wanna say good evening to you. Here come my cows running. They know it's dinner time. I'm late, girls. I'm late. Listen, I wanna drop off this video. Here we are. I'm coming. Listen to all that. Y'all, it is not looking really good in the financial sector, and I hope that you are preparing. So we headed out late this afternoon just to run a few quick errands. I'll be honest with you, I ran to Rural King. I hadn't been there in a while. I wanted to see what their shelves looked like, and I wanted to pick up on a few things. I felt, you know, you can never have too many packs of duct tape, you know, things like that. So I got some duct tape. First and foremost, let me just say right now, while the store, I went to the one in Sweetwater. I also visit the one here in Tennessee in Maryville. I love the one in Crossville. I haven't been to it in a while, but it used to be real nice. And then there's, of course, one out in Halls in North Knoxville area going up towards Union County. But we typically are around, you know, Sweetwater. We go there. Last time I was there was a couple months ago, and it was very... Everything was just kind of knocked around. I've talked about that. And but they had some stuff. Well, what it looks like to us right now, and maybe it's probably just this store, so don't get mad at me. I'm not putting down Rural King. They had less stuff. The store was clean. The store was organized. And James said, well, it's probably organized because they didn't have hardly anything half the time. When you went through the food section, like there's hard, it used to just be jam packed with spices and honey and maple syrup and yeast and all these different things. No, not so much. And there was a lot more wide open spaces. So anyway, here's what my concern is for you. Okay. Not only was there less inventory, now I know this is not at every store, every place, so don't think that I'm trying to paint that picture, but I'm not, but this is what rings in my mind so much that I called my mother. Here's my point. If we get thrown into some type of chaotic situation and we're all just sort of hem-hawing around and not getting stuff, and we get to that point where we've waited, and there's going to be less opportunity to get the things that we need. Okay. What I mean by that is if something happens, you wake up on a Monday morning and it's not good news somehow, and you feel like you need to go get stuff, you're probably going to be scurrying around a whole lot more than you would if you had tried to start getting things prior. Here's what I'm saying. You all know that something's coming. I don't know what, I don't know when, but can you feel it? Can you feel it? I have to tell you, I don't know if you know who Carol Roth is. She's oftentimes, she's been on all kinds of, she gives all kinds of financial expertise, and you can look her up. She's on the Glenn Beck Show a lot. She's on The Blaze a lot, and I really like listening to her when she speaks. I've always found her to be very professional, and I've never found her to be doomsday. I'm going to be honest with you. I know that she doesn't talk like me, but she does paint a clear picture. And so I'm going to attach a picture of what she said today on Twitter, and I'm going to paraphrase it because it's on my phone, so I'm not directly reading it. But basically this afternoon, she came out and basically says that we're going to be having a massive shift in the financial world. And it's basically not one that's going to be on the team of freedom and basically like financial growth. She basically tells you that it's not looking good, and... you better, she said, to prepare. See, I take moments like that when you have individuals that try to stay, they like to keep you updated, they speak their mind, but yet they do try to be a little more conservative. And when people like that come out of the gate and they say, please prepare. Now, that can be 100 different things that you could do. I get that. That's a generic statement. I think she means in the financial world, but I think she also, when you tell somebody to prepare, that means a lot of things. I don't think that means just one thing. That means mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually. How's your pantry looking today? Have you walked your mile? Could you do some jumping jacks? Did you do some push-ups? you know, whatever, you know, get that stress out, build your strength. What have you done today for the preparedness of your family and of your home? So we were already out making a few little runs, and I felt like I needed more duct tape. That's and Flex Seal. That's important stuff to have. And, you know, we were debating the prices at Rural King, which are not as cheap as they used to be. Really, it was really upsetting because folks around here, we like to shop at Rural King and certain places because they typically, not only are at times can they be a little bit more convenient than other places, but also they are typically cheaper. I can tell you right now that we told some folks to start buying their chicken feed from Rural King and not from Tractor Supply because of the price. This has been several months ago, okay? This is not because of all the hullabaloo. This was several months ago, and we said, you can probably get a bag of chicken feed for $10.99, $11.99 at Rural King. So the gentleman would go to Rural King, get a couple bags of chicken feed. He just has a few chickens, and it would last him a bit. Those bags of chicken feed today are $14.29. Now, you may be paying $55 a bag. I get that. The point I'm making is we were noticing just a couple of months ago, something would be $11, now it's $14. Something that was $7.99 is now $11.99. There were a lot of things I didn't end up getting because I said, I don't know if I can get it cheaper somewhere else, but I'm certainly going to try. She's like Walmart. You know how you used, even if you hate Walmart's guts, a lot of people would shop there for convenience, but also because variety and because typically, if you compared it to the local grocery store, Dollar General or whatever, Walmart was cheaper. Not really the case so much depending on what you're buying anymore. So here's the thing. We know something's coming. You know something's coming. If nothing happens, oh my gosh, what'd you do? You bought extra food for your pantry and saved some money? What'd you do? Get some extra duct tape? How dare you? What'd you do? Get extra chicken feed so you don't have to go to the store in a month? I don't know. So don't look at it in negative terms. Look at the positive. If you can't look at it in any other way, look at it as you are going to be saving money because there's no way they're going to be doing the things that they're doing. And you're not going to be paying for it. And you're not going to be hit with more inflation. Folks, that is la-la land. We all need to understand that. You know that. Some of you folks write to me. Some of you folks are just impressive individuals. And you write to me and I'm like, there you go. Listen to him. Listen to her. You know. But here's the thing. We honestly don't know what could be coming in the next couple of weeks or months. Heck, at this point in the game, we don't know what might happen by Monday. If there's something you need to get, if there's something that you need to do and you have been putting it off, please stop today. You have got to, like I said in my last video, honey, you have got to have that butt hair on fire and you have got to be hitting the ground running. This is what you're doing for spring. Yes, you need to plant your gardens. Yes, you need to spring clean. But I am challenging you. I am setting a whole new schedule for myself starting. I knew I was yesterday. That's why we went out today. Starting today, and I've given myself a deadline, May 15th. Let's hope we make it that far, right? I have said I'm going to be doing X amount of things by May 15th. That's giving me, about 7 weeks or so? I just picked a date right after Mother's Day. I'm going to have all of these things done. I will be doing this by then. It's no vacation. I mean, you know, nothing like that. This is the focus. I am challenging you to be doing the same thing. If this is the time that you are seeing in which you should be completely motivated to be moving, don't you wish, let me put it to you this way. For those of you that were seeing some writing on the wall a couple of months before the lockdowns happened, which was, you know, about March 2020? And for those of us that were kind of looking around after Christmas time going, Now, for a lot of people, they were already somewhat prepared. But then the writings on the wall got a little peculiar and you thought, you know what, I better pick up a little extra toilet paper. I'm going to get some coffee and I'm going to do this. And You know what? All of those people now can come to you, and I know you're going to be commenting down below. Please do. Please talk about how preparing even just a little bit has spared you in terms of what we saw 3 years ago, maybe with job loss. We've talked about this till we're blue in the face, but there's always a new person here that has not heard these stories. We have new faces. I'm getting hundreds of new faces every day right now. And I want you all to be baking beans, and I want you to know how to make basic breads, and I want you to have food on the shelf for your babies, and I want you to have an extra pack or five of diapers for your little baby and for your cats to have their cat food or whatever those needs are. I want you to start whittling at them and putting them away. I know a lot of you are doing this. I know a lot of you are trying. I know all of these things. You are the patriots. You are the fighters, this country and other countries as well. So I wanted to drop this off for you. We're coming into the weekend. It's going to be beautiful weather here in East Tennessee. Beautiful weather. We were almost 80 degrees today. 21 the other day with the cat in the tree. 80 today. Go figure. But my point is you right now have an opportunity. Like I said, do you remember a couple of weeks before things got really hectic in 2020? If you had known then what you know now, would you have done something different? Would you have done more? I think a lot of people would have said, I got through just fine because I was prepared, but I would have done more. I think you'll see that. I think it's possible. Let's be smart. Let's be prepared. Folks, the writing is on the wall. The time frame, we don't know. And for those of you that like to say, oh, this is just doomsday and nothing's going to happen, honey, I hope you're right. I'm serious. I'm going to buy you a slider sandwich and a six-pack of mozzarella sticks with marinara at Arby's as a special treat. If you are right and I am wrong, because I want you to be right, okay? But most of all, folks, I want, there she is. I want you to be prepared. Something is coming. When? How bad? How hard? I don't know. See, we don't know if we're going to be, if something's going to happen and then it's going to be just a speed up of things that we're seeing. We don't know. We're not supposed to know, but something is happening. The writing is on the wall. Please prepare this weekend. Start now. Set yourself on a time frame if you can. And like I've said before, you don't have to be burning the dollar in your pocket, although they've already burned it for you. But you don't have to be spending money every single day of your life to be preparing, organizing, getting projects done that you've put off, preparing your grounds, preparing your chicken coops. Get these things done, because folks, if something happens, your mind is going to be elsewhere. Get busy. That's what I'm doing. Join me. Join me. Like, subscribe, and share. I hope you have a fabulous weekend, beautiful weekend. Make every moment and every move count. Appreciate you more than you know. Let me know how those bread recipes are working out for you. They're pretty groovy. We love them. Like, subscribe, and share. And guys, we're going to see you on the next video. We've got work to do. We'll see you then.